What's up guys, Mustang 2005 here. Today I decided I'll do a little walk around in my ST. This is my 2013 Focus ST. And it's not stock, I have modified it. I've actually undone some of my mods. I want to keep the car for longevity. And so I took off some of the mods because, you know, I want this car to last. I don't need to be full power with this car. What it's got now is good enough for me. We'll start back here. This is my Ford Racing Borla exhaust. Ford Racing Performance exhaust, whatever it's called. It's offered by Ford. It comes with a resonator and a muffler. It's pretty cool. It's mellow. It's not too loud. It's not too low. It doesn't drone on the highway. So I like it. It's not too loud. I didn't want it too loud. I also got here mud flaps. It's a typical Focus ST thing. I don't know. Almost every ST owner has the mud flaps. But they look cool. Then we got my wheels. These are the stock wheels, but I had them powder coated a gunmetal. Originally it was like an alloy color and I wasn't crazy about it, and in the year 2014 they changed it to this color, so I just had it powder coated this color. These are covers, they don't come with the car. I did that because I didn't really want to paint them. The paint doesn't last too long. I'm trying to record here. The paint doesn't last too long when you paint them, and it's a pain in the ass to paint them. They are painted, if you see in there a little bit, but they never stay perfect, you know. So I decided to go with the covers. I don't mind my pajama pants and whatever. It's quarantine. So I decided to go with the covers. A lot of people don't like the covers. They say, oh, it's ricey, and oh, you're trying to make you have big brakes. That's not why I got them. I just think they look stylish. And it protects the brakes, it helps with heat dissipation. I just like the look of it. That's all. So, I don't care if you don't like them. I like them. That's why I have them. So I don't have to keep on painting them and stuff. I like the look. It's not because I want to look like I have a big brake kit. The Focus comes with big brakes, but not like Brembo brakes, but they come with pretty decent big brakes. So. These are also aftermarket. These used to be blue with Ford on it. I like these better. And these are aftermarket too. Now if you look along here, this is aftermarket. That is called Easy Lip. It's just to, it's supposed to be like side skirts, like just an extension of the side skirts to just to look a little better. You know, it's Easy Lip. It's not metal or anything, but that's good because this is durable, you know. I don't care. It's just for an extra look. I don't care if it's like not metal or anything. Whatever, that's what I like. It's about what I like, not what everyone else likes. This is my current decal. I've had a few different decals throughout the years on here. This is the one I have currently. I tend to take decals off after a while because I like to switch it up a little bit. Here's my YouTube decal, and this is my dad's car club. And of course I got the stripes, but I'm going to have to redo the stripes because they're getting old and starting to come off. Especially the top one here. This used to be a gloss black and I never really took care of it, so it does have to be redone. Here's my Carlisle decal when I went to Carlisle. These are smoke tinted, the taillights. These are tinted. This here, unfortunately, someone scratched it. I didn't do that. Someone scratched it and I'm still pissed off about it. I just haven't gotten around to fixing it. I'm gonna do it when I do the stripes because just in case they have to repaint all this, I want to make sure I do it when I get rid of these to redo them, because just in case I have to repaint them. My ST badge. Now let's go to the front. Now, I used to have a different look. I had two different looks for this car, besides from stock. The first look, I might put a picture so you see. first look, I had the hood plastic dipped up to here, just the middle part. And it was all black plastic dip. I had the wheels plastic dipped, and I had the back. I had this section here plastic dipped black. That was my first look. My second look, I did away with all that. I got the stripes. And then, the second look, I had fog lights on the grill here. I'll put a picture to that too. After a while, I kind of got tired of the fog lights, the look of it, so I took the fog lights off, but I kept just the stripes. So this is the third look. Even though it's still technically the same, all I did was remove the fog lights, but whatever. So this is the third look. Of course, with the stripes, I'm going to have to get the stripes redone. Because, look at this here. You see it cracking? So I got to get that redone. Another thing that I did here is this. That's pretty cool. It's just a tow strap. It is functional, but I wouldn't actually use it. Because it's only held in by a bolt. And it's noisy again. I apologize. And then down here, my CP front mount intercooler. So that's it for the exterior of the car. That's all I've done so far. Probably all I'm gonna do with the exterior. So now let's take a look at the important part under the hood, and then we'll get to the interior. Okay. All right, so here's the engine, the heart of the car. And there's noisy people coming by, I apologize for that. Okay, as I was rudely interrupted. So, let's start here. This is my CPE intake, that's right, I got CPE everything. This is a carbon fiber battery cover. It just comes off like that. That's real carbon fiber, by the way. The only reason I put it there was for looks, to be honest. I mean, I don't really care that it's carbon fiber. This is also carbon fiber, but I painted it because I didn't want too much carbon fiber to ruin the look. This also comes off just like that. This is my fuse box. Over here, this is my engine cover. I had it hydro dipped and painted the same colors in my car. And a Boomba oil dipstick. Just the handle. And then down here is my Damen oil catch can. And just recently, I had this. This is the oil. This is the sound symposer that comes on the car. Originally, I had it off. I decided to put it back on because I missed the sound of the interior. It's artificial sounding, but I missed it. So that's what that piping is over there. Nothing else is different in here. This is off a Mentos can because the original cover broke off and it was pretty crap. So instead of paying $20 for a replacement that's gonna break again, $2. I might still replace it though, because this blue doesn't match with the rest. This was only temporary. Anyway, this is my coolant. This is also carbon fiber, as you can see. I could probably take these off, but whatever. I'd like to be able to remove it. It's gotta be cleaned, of course, but this is also carbon fiber and painted just to match the theme. This is factory. This funnels air into the intake. And if you look back here, I don't know if you can see it, this thing here, that is a snorkel to feed air. That is aftermarket. It's to feed air even more, ram air into this. So we have ram air intake. I really like this intake though. I think it's the best looking intake. It was the most expensive, but it was the best looking. And you can't really see, but back here, down there would be the turbo, but you can't really see down there. So that is the engine bay. Of course, it needs to be cleaned. Okay, welcome to the interior. So this is the interior of my car. We'll start with the steering wheel. This is all factory. I didn't change anything with it. And you get the ST emblem on the bottom with it. And then down here, this is an aftermarket dead pedal, just to look nice. These are the pedals. Those come factory. Now, behind this gas pedal is a spacer, because the stock location of this was like down here. I don't really heel toe, but it brought the pedal up more to better heel toe. I don't do it, but I like the pedal placement. It feels better. It's easier to rest it here rather than it being down here. You gotta extend your foot more. So that's why I have the spacer there. Over here, we got my shifter, and I like how it matches the stripes. This is actually a Mustang shifter. I got it because of the stripes. You got Ford Racing. You got Ford Racing there. Then over here, I have, this is custom. Over here used to be the sink, the sink badge. I took that off and had this custom made. That is my official build number off of my window sticker or wherever I got it from. I don't remember. I don't remember where I got this, so I apologize. I can't tell you where to get it. This is just for fun. It's actually too big for the switch. This is just for fun, though. It's just this passenger jack, even though it's like too big for the knob. So that's that. Everything else here is factory. I didn't change anything. This is for my phone. Up here I got my recorder, my dash cam, and I got this, you know, gotta represent Italian. And that's all I've really changed on the interior. Nothing, I didn't want to change anything. I wanted it to keep it like factory. These are my seats. This is the ST2. It comes with the color seats instead of the full leather seats. And this is what I wanted. I wanted the color seats. Now this wrap here is custom. This did not come with the car. This I had custom made. It's not a perfect blue matching, but whatever. And the cup holders here, sorry. Those are just, you can get these like anywhere from like a car wash or whatever. It's just to keep it a little bit more clean. Noises, come on, man. All right, well, as I was rudely interrupted again, because people and cars. So anyway, down here, I know I'm jumping all over the place. I gotta clean this a little bit. Here's my custom rug mat. And I know I'm wearing sandals with socks. I don't care right now. So yeah, I did a lot of customization, but not too much, because I didn't want to change it from being stock. I wanted it, you know, stock, how it came. I didn't want to change too much in it. Just enough to enhance it, but not take away from the original look. You know what I mean? So that's the interior. Another thing I put on here was these little things that I got from Wish.com. I thought that was pretty cool. And these come factory. In here, Ford power button. I changed that button because it lights up. The factory button doesn't light up. You're not going to see it right now. Maybe a little bit. There you go. Yeah. So. And you got the ST there. And the Ford. So that's basically the interior of the car. Like I said, I didn't change too much. I didn't want to change too much. The only other thing I did in the engine bay that I forgot to mention is I put shifter bushings inside the engine rather than in the shifter. So it's got... It's more of a mechanic feel. Like you really feel it when it's in gear. It's not a short shifter. It's just better bushing, so you really feel when you're in gear, you know. That's the only other thing that I changed. Now, I used to have a downpipe from CPE as well, and I used to have the Cobb access port. I had a tuner on the car, but I took that off. I took the downpipe off. One, because I had problems with emissions for passing inspection. I didn't want to deal with that bullshit, so I went back to stock. Then I took the tune off because, you know, I want to Yeah, it's nice to have more power, but I never use it. I like getting good gas mileage in this car. This car gets excellent gas mileage. I can get up to 32 miles per gallon on this car. And I don't really drive fast. I mean, here in Staten Island, New York City, you can't really drive fast anyway. There's speed cameras everywhere. There's lights everywhere. You know, it's not even worth it. I don't really go anywhere. This is a 2013. I only have 24,000 miles on it. That tells you how much I actually drive the car. I don't really go anywhere. So, I'd rather get good gas mileage and keep the car for a long time. Because this is a great car to me. It's a hatchback. At first, I wasn't too crazy about it, but the car is pretty practical. You have the space almost like an SUV. It's good in the snow, as long as you have snow tires. It's practical because you get good gas mileage and you get decent speed out of it. It's turbocharged, 250 horsepower from the factory. That might not sound like a lot compared to other cars like an Audi or whatever, for instance. It's good enough. Fine for me, good enough. Like I said, I don't really go anywhere. I don't even boost half the time, to be honest with you. I don't even boost, so. I took most of the mods off, the tune and everything, because it was, why do I need all this power? I don't even use it. So, I'd rather just get, I still got great gas mileage, but to keep the longevity of the car, I just took the tune off. Because you got the factory tune, it's guaranteed nothing's going to go wrong. And I don't beat on the car. So, I'd rather keep it that way. I can't really think of anything else. I got my sunroof. It's my back seats. Like I said, I didn't really change anything in the interior. That's the interior of the car. Let's see the trunk. Here's the trunk of the car. Again, the seats go down and fold all the way down, and you have plenty of space. It's just like an SUV. And this is my custom mat. It got a little dirty over here, unfortunately, but this is my custom mat. Again, I don't really remember where I got any of the stuff that you see in here, so I'm sorry, don't ask me because I don't remember. But this is the trunk. And I guess the only thing left to do is to start it. And that is the walk around of my 2013 Focus ST. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a like, it helps out a lot. Share, subscribe most importantly, and click the bell for notifications so you know when I make another video. See you guys later.